Now that we've talked about the slope and intercept, I'm going to go back to these few lines. What I'm doing here is printing out some performance metrics on both my test data set and also my training data set, just for a point of comparison. Remember, the test data set actually provides the numbers that we're going to trust. Let me go back over here. In the next few videos, we'll be talking pretty exhaustively about the performance metrics that you can use to evaluate your regressions. But let me give you a sneak preview here. One performance metric that we'll talk about is something called R squared. And to make a long story short, the higher your R squared is, the better. R squared has a maximum value of 1. And so what we can do is we can ask for this regression that we've just made, how good is our R squared? And we want to be asking that question of our test data set. If we ask it of our training data set, we'll also get some interesting information, but only by using the test data set can we be sensitive to things like overfitting. So when I go over here and I look at the values of my R squared score for my test data set and then also my training data set for comparison, I get a little bit of information about how well my regression is performing. I said the maximum value is 1.0. The maximum value for R squared is 1.0. So since I'm getting 0.81 on the test data set and 0.87 on the training data set, I'm actually not doing too badly. So rather than talking about R squared anymore, let's go back to the tablet and we'll talk some more about the types of errors that you can have on regressions and how you can quantify them so that you really understand what these numbers mean.